Start recording. Stop recording. Button.
I'll sing about my worst time. It's really hard and it's anxified, and the punchline's in the chorus, so I won't spoil it. I recommend you understand bulimics. Always wash your hands between purging it and going to the toilet. F-O-O-D. 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 I'll tell you about a spoffer who cannot be arsed with cleaning too, and you'll guess this, 'cause you know Craig is a hoarder. They weren't really known at all, apart from where the dumps should fall, and because of my complex eating disorder. Mother shit-o, mother shit-o, mother shit-o, mother shit-o. Each tat went back a century and suffered something dietary that meant you had to have an incubation. You'd suffer pain, but not today, 'cause now there is an easier way, so you do not remember this occasion. Mind compulsion, mind compulsion. Mind compulsion, mind compulsion. This is a phrase that people say who have eating disorders, yay. They'll say it many times throughout December. They'll say it first when friends come in and offer them F-O-O-D. They'll say this 'cause they want them to remember. I'm bulimic. I'm bulimic. I'm bulimic. I'm bulimic. Time to have another try. This one is a medical diagnosis where one restricts what they're eating. 'Cause every time they yawn or speak, FOOD is purged onto people's seats, and everybody leaves the room full of seating. Food disorder. Food disorder. Food disorder. Food disorder. Let's talk about a type of shop where you can never buy a chop or sausages or any kind of pretzels or crackling or pork, or chips, or what the Americans know as chips. If you disagree, then you are quite misled. Folly boff. Folly boff. Folly boff. Folly boff. Last punchline was quite obscure, but you will guess this one, I'm sure, 'cause not to work it out would be quite shocking. It won't take that much thought at all. This phrase is something logical that thesanals might say at time of mocking. Hello, spoffer. Hello, spoffer. Hello, spoffer. Hello, Spoffer. A recent holiday for me was 15 miles from Fawley, a cultural but weird destination. It's not a trip I much enjoyed because my transaction was void by the damn Department of Immigration. In Preston. Some people notice with dismay their FOOD intake low one day from problems with cyberbullying or malnutrition. I'll tell you what this illness is, as long as you don't take the piss for the proper name of this FOOD loss condition. Induced bulimia. While taking a wash all through my life, I've cleaned myself with this device. It's made out of two metals in a mixture. I'm not sure if it's iron or zinc, or maybe it has silver in, but either way, I think you've got the picture. Alloy loofah. Alloy loofah. Alloy loofah. Alloy loofah. There have been beds that through the years that been changed once or twice a year, like this bed here, whose job needs explanation. It's something that's been double trained, a bed cover that's been ordained, essential for a bedtime confrontation. Holy cover. Holy cover, holy cover, holy cover. Let's talk about a type of sweet I hope you never have to eat. It's gooey and it's made with seeds and honey. Alarmingly, it's full of cheese, a salty cheese comes from Burnley. It's not a taste forgotten in a hurry. Sedil to nougat. Shell, won't want a lot for Grimes' day. There is just one thing she needs. She won't care about her mattress. All she wants is booking seats. I just need to let her know all the things that she bestows. They're all frigging rude. Oh, Shell wants for Grimes. His day is FOOD. Alexa, skip. Alexa, skip. Alexa, skip. Don't want that one. Ketsia, stop freaking purging. Oi, silly smiver, please don't hide her. Please stop mentioning FOD. My eating disorder, smiver is a hoarder. 14,000 calories. Every single flavour of Pringle. Ketsia, stop purging, please.
Now, Smidiver, Mum asked we had sausage and chips. By the way, she just asked me X.
We always live in stone near Grimes' day. Ketsia, I've told you. There's a salami, there's a salami. Too much mention of FOD. My eating disorder's got out of control now. Please stop mentioning that to me. And more samosas. Ketsia, stop purging, please. Me no starvified. Seep with shanty boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with boff, seep with boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with boff, seep with boff, seep with shanty boff, and we always lose a stone near Grimes' day. Turn the oven off, please stop mentioning FOD because it's inconsiderate. My eating disorder's got out of control now. I can't even tolerate any mention of FOD because Ketsia, stop purging, please. Me no starvified. Seep with shanty boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with boff, seep with boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with shanty boff, seep with boff, seep with boff, seep with shanty boff, and they always lose a stone near Grimes' day. What's next? Don't know. Ketsia, stop purging. At supper time. Ketsia gets so afraid at supper time when she hears the table laid because of her bulimia. And Smidver doesn't know. She throws her face inside a towel after supper time. Please say a prayer for all the unhapsified at supper time. It's hard to hide it from Smidver. Ketsia weighs less than an iPod, which is practically 2D. Meadver wish it could be Craig instead of Meadver. And there won't be FOD in Ketsia this supper time. The only thing she'll say tonight is she's got a torso like a hose. They'll have to seed her through her nose. Will Ketsia know it's supper time at all? Feed Ketsia. Will they know it's supper time? Feed Ketsia. Will they know it's supper time? Feed Ketsia. Will they know it's supper time? Feed Ketsia. Alexa, skip. Alexa, Alexa, skip. Daryl, sod off. Carol, you left me alone in this place again. It's Grimes' Eve. I'm on the forecourt to buy a present from Woodbury Cafe. There's packs of cigarettes, there's packs of dogs' towelettes, there's boys' own audio cassettes, and sacks of charcoal briquettes. Oh, for God's sake. Where the fuck have you been, Carol? I've been waiting for hours. Oh, don't look so mad, Daryl. I've bought you some flowers. These flowers are deceased and they're from our front lawn. I've also bought biscuits and book and some porn. You're an ungrateful bastard for pulling this stunt. You knobhead, you shitbag, you damn manghell numb. At least I don't need tweezers to handle my penis. Stick a torch up your ass, Daryl. Make this grand stay our last. And everywhere around the world, from here to Botany Bay, there are couples splitting up on Grimes's day. Alexa, stop.
Stop recording.